Today I'm going to go over an optimized version of the Heapify function. You have to use the basic intro to heap video first. Little history. Heap sort was introduced by Williams in 1964 based on some earlier work. A few changes. He used a min heap and also didn't use the linear time heap build operation, but those were rectified or revised by Floyd later in the year. Another couple changes, which we'll talk about a little bit more today. He compared the two children first. Also, he didn't actually swap things down when doing Heapify. The reason that I illustrated the version that I illustrated, well, it matches the Cormen version, which can be coded more nicely in a, say, recursive way, if you like. It's a good way to visualize, but what if you really want to optimize? So what do I mean when I say optimize the code? Am I talking about number of comparisons? Am I talking about machine level code? Let's start with number of comparisons. Well, how are we going to use asymptotic notation? Do we use it for the entire function? Or do we use it for just the smaller order terms? Do we say it's order n log n or exactly 2n log n plus order n comparisons? Knuth and Sedgwick use sort of this more detailed analysis. So Floyd's next suggested change was, you know, follow the path of the larger child without actually comparing the element to its children. Then bubble back up towards the root as needed. For a single deletion, you expect to have exactly log n plus order a constant number of comparisons. Now, in the worst case, that value can go all the way back up and take something like 2 log n comparisons. But in heap sort as a whole, if you run this over and over, it can't take more than something like 3/2 log n on average per deletion, or 3/2 n log n total comparisons for heap sort plus the linear number overall. Now, coming back to the other issue, if you don't actually swap all the way down, but we compare the two children, and now let's look at the actual children that get compared all the way down, and let's consider the path that we have down to a leaf. Because it's a heap, that path has to be sorted, and instead of doing a linear search to go back up, we could actually do a binary search to go back up. After we do the binary search to figure out where we go, well, then we can actually move our data around. Okay, here again, I'm going to show the data moving by swapping, but really each of the up to log n things move up once, and the thing that was at the top moves down once. This gives us log n plus log log n comparisons per deletion, or n log n plus order n log n total comparisons, where that first term, the n log n term, has no constant hiding in front of it. We can actually make this even a little bit better if we're willing to pay a bit more complexity in our code. First, instead of going all the way down to the leaf, just find the path most of the way down to the leaf. Stop log log n away from the bottom of the tree and check the value there. If it's supposed to be closer to the root, you do a binary search on the top of the tree. But that binary search is sort of already paid for by the amount of the bottom of the tree that you didn't search. If you have to go closer to the leaf, we'll just recurse on the rest of the tree. But there, your binary search is going to be much smaller because there's so much less of the tree on the bottom. This gives you a few extra checks to get down to the leaf, a total of log star n of them in the worst case. But your binary search is essentially already paid for. This will give you an n log n plus order n log star n comparison, worst and average case heap sort. Compare that to the simple n log n plus order n expected heap sort comparisons for the simple algorithm, where you just compare the two children, move down, and then move back up as you get to the bottom. It's your choice. Okay, so I've mentioned lots of references without giving the full detail, but of course, if you want to see the detail, go read the papers. They're all fantastic. All right, I haven't actually read half of them, and some of the other ones I skimmed. Hey, all right. Anyway, for a very good place to start, the dissertation of Robert Schaefer, very nice. Please subscribe. Right now I have to go. The Power Rangers are on.